These are TRISO particles. It is the most robust nuclear fuel available. In our factory, we combine a series of powders, solutions, and gases to create these fuels to withstand extreme temperatures and radiation. This is how it's made. The fabrication process is composed of two parts. First, the fabrication of TRISO particles, and second, the fabrication of FCM fuel pellets containing those TRISO particles. The first step is to package uranium into spherical kernels using the sol gel process. Uranium oxide is dissolved in nitric acid to make a broth solution of uranyl nitrate. The liquid broth is cooled to low temperatures and dispersed as droplets into an oil bath. This bath is warm, and the droplets undergo thermally activated reactions that solidify the droplets into soft gel spheres, a few millimeters in diameter. The spheres gently flow to collectors, where they are cleaned, rinsed, and drained. This pilot line can produce 2 kilograms of uranium fuel kernels per hour, which is an energy equivalent to 600,000 liters of diesel per hour, or 24 truck tanks. The kernels are prepared for a high-temperature furnace. The kernels are coated with a series of engineered ceramic layers using chemical vapor deposition. The thickness, porosity, grain size, and texture are strictly controlled to achieve the desired performance. Gases are flowed to create a fluidized bed, which mixes and suspends the particles inside the chamber. In this way, the particles are kept airborne, and layers can be chemically deposited evenly and consistently. The particles can now be sorted and selected to ensure we only deliver high-quality spherical particles of a specific diameter. One by one, size separation is achieved using roller pins or screens. Misshapen or non-spherical particles are sorted using an inclined vibratory plane. During the fabrication process, each lot of TRISO particles and FCM fuel pellets are randomly sampled, and key measurements and inspections are performed. Optical microscopy is used to measure the thickness of TRISO layers and the UC2 fraction in TRISO kernels from ceramographic cross-sections and shadow imaging. The images are analyzed using automated image analysis routines to allow efficient and unbiased collection of data. The TRISO particles are now ready to be embedded in a solid pellet. We embed the particles in silicon carbide to enhance fission product retention and structural stability of the fuel form. Binder jet powder printers form the vessels for the TRISO particles. Additively manufacturing the shells allows for complex geometries and rapid prototyping without retooling. This additive manufacturing method produces parts by stacking layers of bonded powders. The powder bed is baked in an oven to complete the cure. After a few hours, the parts can be depowdered in a dedicated hood. The shells, also called green bodies, can now be filled with TRISO particles. We pour a mixture of TRISO particles and silicon carbide powder into the shells using vibrations to get maximal packing. We can now use chemical vapor infiltration to fill in the gaps and achieve a sealed layer on the outside of the pellet. Parts are loaded on a multi-level retort. Gas is flowed at high temperatures to deposit reaction products onto the ceramic surfaces. After several days of deposition, the densification is complete and the pellets are removed for final inspection. Industry standard TRISO fuel are encased within a fully dense silicon carbide matrix. This combination provides an extremely rugged and stable fuel with extraordinary high temperature stability.